So South Korea, New Zealand, Japan and Canada could become new partners with AUKUS.
Yeah, they actually joined Japan that already had talks with the three core AUKUS nations, Australia, the UK and the United States, really for discussions about what an expansion might look like, what the commitments might be. This does not mean at this point an actual expansion, but particularly not around the submarines, but around that pillar two, the advanced and emerging technologies, how they can collaborate together. Some of the questions that they have to dig into are what resources each of those countries will actually bring to bear, how they can contribute to this, and what they might get from it.
The bigger it gets, the more it winds up China.
There is certainly a coalitional aspect to this that is advantageous to this that drives China crazy. That's true.
I guess the bigger it gets as well, Charles, you know, there's so much secrecy around the technology that's being used here. To share that to three or four more countries is quite a gamble, isn't it?
Well, it is, but I think the conversations have always revolved around what countries can bring to the package, what they can bring to the fight here, too. And we know that of the countries that we're talking, Canada and New Zealand are already part of the Five Eyes Intelligence Consortium. So our intelligence information controls are not perfectly synced. We know even Australia's wasn't personally synced at the beginning of the process, but are quite close. The more interesting one is South Korea and Japan, because as non-Five Eye members, but as countries that have enormous capabilities in advanced computing and quantum, in missile technology, they bring a lot, but there will be more work to do on aligning information controls.
Fair bit of chit-chat about Donald Trump and that he may not like AUKUS, but that's unlikely to happen if he gets here, and he won't mess with it, will he?
Well, that's an open question because he hasn't said very much about AUKUS, which is why I think there's some anxiety around this. That said, there's a very plausible and useful argument to be made about how AUKUS increases the salience, the strength, and the punching power of Americans' allies who are paying for strengthening themselves. Those seem like rather attractive pitches to someone like Donald Trump, I'd imagine.
Well, you're only here for 3 days, so do you get to go out and hit the town?
Absolutely. I've been running all over Sydney, not the marathon, and down here in Canberra, too.
Very good.
I always love it to see
Enjoy.
You.
AUKUS is set to open its door to new countries in a bid to expand the alliance and cooperate on advanced technology. Let's go live to Today Federal Politics reporter Liz Daniels in Canberra. Liz, three nations want in on the pact.
That's right, Jane. The tight AUKUS trio of Australia, the UK and the US could embrace what's called a Pillar 2 partnership with South Korea, New Zealand and Canada. It would be aimed at sharing advanced technologies that could pave the way for the development of autonomous vehicles, uncrewed submarines and even electronic and cyber warfare to help evolve our capabilities on an ever-changing battlefield and against a backdrop of China's military rise. The potential cooperation is floated in a joint statement that has just been released by the Prime Minister, his UK counterpart and the US President, marking 3 years since the original AUKUS Defence Pact was signed. That pact was focused on the submarine deal, a nuclear submarine deal. That one is not expected to be expanded beyond the three core members, but progress on the deal will be on the agenda when the Prime Minister sits down with Joe Biden at the Quad Leaders meeting in the US state of Delaware this weekend, amid concerns that slow production might mean we don't get the three Virginia-class boats delivered from the early 2030s as promised. There are fears too, Jane, that if Donald Trump is returned to the White House, he could throw out the agreement altogether. An important trip coming up for the Prime Minister.
Absolutely, Liz. Thank you.